Once the racket has dropped a foot below, once you get to here, now you're going to drop the racket down, the front foot's going to step out. Okay, so we drop it down, the front foot steps out. Now, where does the racket go from here? Remember, it's going to go forward and up. So as we go forward and up, we want the legs and the body to be doing the same thing because we want the body and the racket to be in sync. Okay, so the legs are going up, the racket's going up, and you lift. That's the idea. Now, some players will do this. They'll bend really well, but they stay down with their legs and then their arms trying to go up. And you've got forces going in opposite directions. The legs are going down and the arms trying to go up. It's very difficult. Remember, you want your racket and your body in sync. So once you drop it down, front foot goes out. Now lift and lean forward. That's the way you're going with the racket, and that's where you want your body to go. Forward and up. Okay, you want the racket and the body moving in sync. You want the racket just basically to be an extension of your body. Remember, from the ready position, when you turn your body, the racket comes back. Now where do you go? Remember, you're going to drop it down at least a foot below the ball before you swing forward and up. Now, the racket from this position is going to go forward and up. So the body should do the same thing. Sometimes I'll see players go down and they stay down. And then the arms trying to go up, and it's a real tough shot because you've got a force. Your legs are going down and your arm is going up. You've got forces in opposite directions. So remember, once you get to this position, now the racket's going to go forward and up, and the body should be doing the same thing, forward and up. Okay, I'm going to practice that now. Try and get my racket and my body moving together. Notice the racket and body moving together on the backswing. Now notice the racket and body move forward and up together. Okay, once we've completed the first part of our swing, where do we go from there? Okay, remember, from your ready position, you're going to get your racket back quickly. Turn the shoulders, get the racket back. Now, where does the racket go from here? Remember, if you're hitting a drive or hitting with topspin, the racket has to drop down below the contact point, at least 1 foot below. That's where the rear end goes down, like you're sitting on a chair. Okay? Now, your left hand can really help you too to get that racket back and down. All right? The left hand is not there as an ornament. Remember, it can help you keep the racket face closed and also help you drop the racket a foot below the contact point. Okay, notice too, as I drop it down, the front foot steps out. See how the front foot goes out? That'll enable you to transfer your weight to your front leg and keep your balance. Then once you're there, you're going to lift into the shot with your legs as you come through. Remember, that lift gives you power and it gives you depth. So that's it. From the ready position, once we get to here, the racket's going to drop down. Remember to use the left hand. Use that left hand, keep the face closed. Then lift as you're hitting the ball and continue to lift with a high finish. Notice the legs straighten out on the finish. Okay, I'm going to practice sitting down now and stepping out, and then I'm going to lift as I hit the ball. Here we go. Sometimes you'll even come off the ground because the force of lifting come up a little. I hit that one a little late. There we go.
Notice here the lead foot steps out and the legs lift up and forward into the shot.
That's the idea. So it's a sitting, step out as you go down. That way you can transfer the weight forward. A couple more. A little late. There we go. Okay, and that's the idea. That sitting and lifting, remember, is going to ensure your net clearance power and another drill to ensure that we're getting the net clearance that we need. Remember, we've got to get that racket a foot below the contact point before we swing forward and up. So our two key points are sit in the chair and then get out of the chair. Sit in the chair will help you to bend your knees and get the racket down. Now remember, wherever you're contacting the ball, whether it's knee high, waist high, or shoulder high, wherever it is, you have to get the racket at least a foot lower than that point. So our two key points again, sit in the chair, get out of the chair. Now remember to get out of the chair, that way that the racket and the body will be moving in sync. Remember, if you bend and stay down like this, you don't want to keep your body down and the racket's trying to go up, then you would have forces in opposite directions. So remember to lift with your legs, get out of the chair. Okay, here we go. Remember the two key points. Sit in the chair, get out of the chair. Here we go.
At this point, the rear end is down, like I'm going to sit in a chair. Then I get out of the chair as I strike the ball.